I would like to say thank you. Thank you so much to my sponsor, Jeff and Bonnie Mori. I hope I see you one day. I love you so much, wherever you are.
How about today?
My name is Nora Birungi. I'm currently a substitute teacher, and currently I work in one of the schools in my community.
We are Jeff and Bonnie Mori, and we had the opportunity to sponsor Nora over 20 some years ago. When we were told we had the chance to meet Nora, I was almost speechless because we had no idea. We had no idea how much she had grown. We had no idea of the young woman that she became. We saw that she was this advocate for children and for compassion. And then it just felt very humbling. We did something so little. We felt like it was just so little. And then Jeff and I started realizing as we're looking at the small portion that we did and not looking at the magnification that God did. And that is through all of the compassion team.
My time in compassion, there is this particular teacher I remember, she's called Ruth, that impacted so much on me. Actually, even the desire for me to become a teacher came from her. My desire for math and English came from her. She could sit down giving her whole time just for me to understand. So for me as a child, I admired her so much. The other person would be our youth pastor. To me, he was like a father figure, very passionate about God, but also showed us a very good example. He taught us how to pray. He always made sure that we are fine, but also always encouraging us and reminding us of what the Bible tells us about our lives.
It's not just us. It's a whole team. It's a whole army of people that God mobilizes in order to affect change in the life of a child. This picture of what we're doing is very little, but there's so much going on in the background. And as that happens, it grew her and it made her who she is today, which who would have ever thought that she would then get to go to university, get her bachelor's degree in social services, and she's able to move her entire family here to the United States, in which she still wants to give back to compassion, but she comes here and still continues on as a compassion advocate. And little by little, God opens the door for someone to reach us to say, she's looking for you.
I hope I see you one day. I love you so much, wherever you are.
How about today?
No.
Yes.
And eventually this is possible. And it's just like that goes all the way back to a compassion team giving her hope.
If those tough were not that compassion, I don't think my life would be the way it is today. I don't think so. No, I wouldn't.
I would love to tell the staff workers at the Compassion Project there in Uganda, thank you, because you reached in and not only were Jesus's hands, but were my hands. You were not only my voice, but you were Jesus's voice. And together, what they did was so much more than what I could do in just a single letter. But yet, it was because of their involvement, even far more than my letters, that changed Nora's life, that brought us to the point where we were able to meet. To realize that you have even your small role to play, because that small role doesn't stop with you. It continues on and it lights a candle that lights another candle that lights another candle, and it becomes exponential. and that's in the hands of our God.